Fans love shipping their favorite stars, but it's hard not to look away when an A-lister's dirty laundry comes to light. Let's take a look back at the carnage 2020 has wreaked on some superstars whose careers appear to be completely done. Stassi Schroeder and Kristen Doty were the queen bees on Vanderpump Rules until June 2020. Page Six reported that Schroeder lost brand deals with Ritual and Billy after former castmate Faith Stowers recalled a 2018 incident where Schroeder and Doty accused her of a crime she didn't commit.
I guess this woman was like robbing people and stealing like gold bars, and they called the cops and said it was me.
Schroeder actually bragged about the in-depth investigation of Stowers she and Doty undertook in a now-deleted interview on The Bitch Bible. Schroeder apologized on Instagram, but it wasn't enough, as more of her past incidents of racial insensitivity resurfaced, including describing herself as, quote, Nazi chic in a 2018 Instagram story, and complaining about black people wanting representation in film during a 2017 podcast. After Variety revealed that Schroeder and Doty got fired from Vanderpump Rules, they both publicly apologized. Stowers told People, however, that while Doty did DM her, Schroeder never reached out privately. Us Weekly confirmed Schroeder's podcast was removed from all platforms, and her wine line with Doty was pulled from stores. Doty seemingly didn't have as much to lose as Schroeder, but her publisher did stop promoting her book after just 1 week of sales. According to Deadline, Schroeder and Doty began working with a crisis management team in the wake of the scandal. After years of telling fans to be kind, talk show staffers accused Ellen DeGeneres of creating a, quote, toxic work culture in a June 2020 BuzzFeed News expose.
So former employees who worked on The Ellen Show told me that they experienced a range of sexual harassment and misconduct and witnessed a range of it.
Even fellow celebs started dogpiling onto DeGeneres, but DeGeneres herself kept quiet until The Ellen DeGeneres Show returned in September 2020. She said, "I learned that things happened here that never should have happened. I take that very seriously, and I want to say I am so sorry to the people who were affected." The show continued, but it wasn't business as usual. According to BuzzFeed News, The Ellen Show Instagram account dropped sponsored brands posts from 8 to 2 different brands. Those numbers could be attributed to many factors, including the pandemic. But publicists also told BuzzFeed News that they don't want to book clients as guests to be a part of, quote, her comeback tour. As one put it, you don't want to put your client in any line of fire sympathizing with someone that any community or anyone would feel bad about. We're not going to align anyone with Ellen. BuzzFeed also noted that in October 2020, DeGeneres' ratings declined about 37% from last season, which is nearly double the average for other syndicated talk shows. Yes, DeGeneres is clearly still a major fixture on daytime TV, but is her brand permanently tainted, or is this just a momentary hiccup? In June 2020, Lea Michele was called out by fellow Glee alum Samantha Ware after posting a tweet promoting Black Lives Matter. In a since-deleted response tweet, Ware accused Michele of making her, quote, first television gig a living hell, saying, "I believe you told everyone that if you had the opportunity, you would in my wig," amongst other traumatic microaggressions that made me question a career in Hollywood. Ware told Variety Michele changed after Ware's first performance, recalling, "That's when it started. The silent treatment, the stare downs, the looks, the comments under her breath, the weird passive aggressiveness.
Let's get started."
After Ware's claims, other celebs shared their unflattering allegations about Michelle's on-set behavior. Glee alum Heather Morris slammed Michelle for, quote, treating others with the disrespect that she did, but would not go so far as to call Michelle racist. Michelle lost a HelloFresh sponsorship, while a spokesperson for Zola, a company that worked with Michelle to plan her 2019 wedding, told Newsweek they were, quote, deeply disappointed by the news concerning her conduct. Their partnership, however, had already ended with the wedding.
"I have made the very hard and difficult decision to not be a part of Real Housewives of Atlanta season 13.
Although NeNe Leakes maintained that she made the decision to leave the hit Bravo series, her own remarks contradict that. When a fan tweeted the star asking about a spinoff, she replied, "They don't think I deserve to work at all in any capacity." When she was asked if Bravo had forced her out, Leakes responded with, quote, "They definitely did.
I had an offer on the table. I did not think the offer was a fair offer."
When Real Housewives executive producer Andy Cohen had Leaks' frenemy Wendy Williams on Watch What Happens Live, Leaks tweeted up a storm, calling Cohen a, quote, old racist, and declaring, "No one knew you until you knew me. Remember, I'm Icon. Don't forget." She slammed Cohen for low ratings, in addition to writing, "Keep trying me, sir, and I'ma let the world know who you really are." In October, Leaks told Tamron Hall she wanted to meet with Bravo to demand, quote, fair treatment. Since she's no longer on the network, however, the possibility of that meeting seems very unlikely. Kelly Dodd's unfiltered personality provides entertainment on The Real Housewives of Orange County, but it's not a facade she puts on for the cameras. She doesn't hold back, whether she's on TV or not. Page Six reported that Dodd called coronavirus, quote, God's way of thinning the herd in an April 2020 Instagram story. A month later, she compared coronavirus to the flu, remarking, "Well, people are going to die. I'm sorry to tell ya." In yet another IG story a few weeks later, she said, "No one is wearing masks here in Orange County. Yep. Because no one is dying here of the virus." In September 2020, Dodd declared via Instagram that coronavirus is, quote, not a pandemic anymore, to which her boss, Andy Cohen, finally said, "Her posts show how woefully uninformed we all are." Dodd's cringeworthy statements aren't limited to global pandemics. In a resurfaced 2016 TMZ video, she says, "I don't like black guys. I don't even know any black guys." Dodd, who is Mexican-American, quickly apologized amid backlash and even claimed that she's also been a victim of racism.
In hindsight, it was the stupidest thing I've ever said.
In October 2020, Vice reported on the social media drama and the growing number of Real Housewives viewers who've publicly boycotted both Dodd and the show. That month, Showbiz Cheat Sheet confirmed that the season 15 premiere generated lower ratings than previous seasons. The decrease can't be solely attributed to the Dodd backlash, but it doesn't bode well for her reality TV future. Once a season of The Bachelor ends, most cast members become social media influencers. But what happens when an influencer deletes their social media? In November 2020, Us Weekly reported that Colton Underwood deleted his Instagram photos, every single one. That's certainly an unexpected move for someone with 2 million followers, who spent years building a brand contingent on social media promotion. Yes, Underwood has other streams of revenue, including sales from his book The First Time, Finding Myself, and Looking for Love on reality TV. But he's missing out on that Instagram ad money by halting his posting. Only Underwood can verify why he blanked out his IG page, but his post-TV life has no shortage of drama. In September 2020, TMZ obtained legal documents that Underwood's ex, Cassie Randolph, filed for a restraining order against him. She claimed that he put a tracking device on her car, harassed her via text message, and showed up uninvited to her apartment and to her parents' home. Additionally, she alleged that he, quote, sent anonymous text messages to her and to himself, pretending to also be a victim of the anonymous stalker.
I was almost pushing her away by trying to bring her closer.
In October 2020, Underwood told Us Weekly that Cassie had, quote, asked the court to dismiss the temporary restraining order against me, claiming that they resolved their issues privately. TMZ later confirmed that Randolph dropped the restraining order and sought to end a police investigation into Underwood. That appeared to be the end of their public drama, but what about Underwood's Instagram career? Chris D'Elia found fame as a comedian and an actor in TV shows, including Whitney and You. That success came crashing down in June 2020 when five women spoke to the Los Angeles Times, accusing D'Elia of exposing himself and other sexual improprieties. Two of those women claimed they were under 18 when they had encounters with D'Elia, one of whom allegedly began corresponding with him when she was 17 and he was 36.
What do you want me to say? What, I'm a sicko? Okay, fine, I'm bad.
In September 2020, CNN shared accusations from two additional women who had similar experiences, including traumatic unwanted advances in which D'Elia exposed himself. D'Elia's lawyer shared a statement with Variety, declaring, "D'Elia denies these allegations and emphatically states that he has never engaged in any sexual conduct with any woman without her consent." Even so, his career will probably never be the same. Deadline reported that he was dropped by his talent agency and management company. Netflix ditched plans for an unscripted prank show that he was supposed to partake in. He also got replaced in the upcoming movie Army of the Dead. D'Elia has bigger worries than missing the opportunity to prank randoms on a Netflix show, but the lost jobs and lack of industry support will undoubtedly have a lasting impact on his career. Good lawyers don't come cheap. A breakup can be tough on its own, but Johnny Depp's split from Amber Heard took things to another level, damaging his reputation and career. The drama kicked into high gear when Amber wrote an op-ed about domestic violence for the Washington Post in December 2018. Although he wasn't mentioned in the piece, Depp's lawyers slapped Heard with a $50 million defamation lawsuit the following March 2019. Depp said that Heard's accusations, quote, cost him the role of Jack Sparrow in Disney's Pirates of the Caribbean franchise. That wasn't the only job he lost, though. In December 2020, Warner Brothers told Deadline that Depp would be leaving the Fantastic Beasts franchise.
I think what Johnny Depp has said is that he can't get a job, you know.
Depp admitted on Instagram that he was, quote, asked to resign by the studio from the film he'd already begun to shoot. While his tenure with the franchise is over, Depp didn't lose a paycheck, thanks to a clause in his contract that stipulated he would be paid regardless of whether or not he actually appears in the movie. Depp lost his libel case against United Kingdom publication The Sun in November 2020. The judge concluded that the outlet's, quote, use of the phrase wife beater was justified, as Heard's allegations against Depp were, quote, substantially true. Despite the loss, Depp will pursue another defamation lawsuit in the United States starting in May 2021, which could have even more detrimental effects on his career. If you or someone you know is dealing with domestic abuse, you can call the National Domestic Violence Hotline at 1-800-799-7233 or TTY 1-800-787-3224. You can also find more information, resources, and support at www.thehotline.org.